Having an open date after their season opener, Razorback football had plenty of time to prepare for their game against Georgia. In fact, head coach Brian Petrino said they'd been planning that conference opener since the spring, and Saturday night Arkansas would find out if that extra work paid off. Also doing in front of a national audience, Hogs playing on ESPN, also playing in Fayetteville for the first time this season. Razorbacks go to work after recovering a drop punt return. Here's Ryan Mallett. Perfect play action rollout pass to Joe Adams, 18-yard touchdown. Hogs go up 7-0. Game tied at 7 a little later in the first. Following drive, first play no less. Mallett goes for it all, and Jarius Wright takes it in for a 48-yard touchdown. Hogs back on top, it's 14-7. If you like that one, this play is absolutely incredible. Following Hog drive, Mallett going deep again. Greg Childs, the extension and the grab. Awesome. Take another look at this. Reaches out, brings it in. They had to review it. And it was a touchdown. Hogs now on top 21-7. But unfortunately for the Razorbacks, Georgia makes a big plays too. Here's Richard Samuel on a second and long. And he's the one going a long way, trying 80 yards for the touchdown. Bulldogs led this game 27-21 at the half. The Razorbacks weren't finished yet. Coming out, guns blazing in the third. Here's Mallett to Greg Childs again. And then totally keeps Brandon Boykin, one of the better defensive backs in the SEC, off him. Enough for a 40-yard touchdown. Sweet Childs of mine. The Hogs are back on top, 28-27. Hogs coming from behind yet again. That was a third and goal play action pass to DJ Williams. Touchdown makes it 35-34 Arkansas. Now the Bulldogs only needed two plays on the next drive to take it back. Here's Orson Charles, had both catches in the drive. Takes it in for the go-ahead score for Georgia. Two-point conversion made it 42-35. Great effort, but Georgia never trailed again. Arkansas goes down 52-41. Ryan Mallett set a pair of school records, 408 yards and five touchdowns, as the Hogs dropped to 1-1 on the season.
You know, I think the first thing we have to do is not hurt ourselves, not beat ourselves, and then you have a better opportunity to beat somebody else. But we had too many penalties. We had some blown assignments out there, which allowed them to score quick, which hurt us. And then offensively, you know, we had the ball down there inside the 20 twice and had to settle for field goal, and then, you know, couldn't keep up in the scoring battle when we had to do that.
In the second half, there's a couple plays I could have made and I didn't. You know, that's the, you know, you go back and watch that on film and you're like, man, I could have made that. Ball game's a different outcome, but it's not. Can't go back and change anything. Just got to go get ready for next.
I think we came out early. We had a couple big stops. And then, you know, we had some players that go missing on us, which, you know, none of them planned it. It wasn't anything of negativity or anything like that. It's just that, you know, we had a couple guys missing, and that hurt us.
Let's do some thinking inside the box. In the box score, Ryan Mallett, as mentioned a little earlier, set a pair of school records, 408 yards passing, five touchdowns. He was 21-39. Also, Greg Childs making huge plays, trying five catches, 140 yards, and a pair of touchdowns. 78 of the Hogs' 100 penalty yards all came in the second quarter, and it really stalled that Arkansas offense.